Good evening. It's me, Clarence, the plant. Today, we will show you how to make me so I can exist in your world as well. The more of me, the better.
This project requires the Armor Statues data pack and the Vanilla Tweaks More Mob Heads data pack to be installed. First, we'll start with a base. Place the flower pot on whichever block you want it on. Then place an armor stand in front of it. This will be for our stem. In your statue book, hit Show Arms Yes, and make sure that gravity is turned off. Then, using the presets menu, set it to attention so that all of the limbs are aligned. Give the stand the drip leaf. Then go to Pose Adjust, right arm, X plus, X plus, to make sure the stem is pointing upward. From there, use your adjustment wand to align the stem to the center of the pot. You'll want to leave a little gap of air between the top of the pot and the bottom of the stem. This is for extra height. We will cover up the hole later. Now we're going to get started on the leaves. Place an armor stand down, show the arms, turn the gravity off, and after you give it the leaf, turn it to the small stand. Set it to the preset pose attention again, and then move the arm upwards just like last time. To save ourselves time, we're going to click Utilities and Copy. Then, whenever we do this again, we can paste the stand and won't have to adjust it every time. Don't forget to lock your stand. Click Utilities, Lock, and that will prevent this stand from being edited again. In other words, don't do what I did. Now using the adjustment wand, move the drip leaf into place. It should be aligned with the center of the front of the pot, but not directly in the middle of it. You'll want to make sure the stem is in the pot and not sticking outside of it. Once it's in place, lock that stand. Use the paste command to get back the pose from the previous stand. We're going to repeat the same process on all three of the other sides, making sure they face outward in different directions. Once all four leaves are in, we can move on to the head and the jaw. Let's start out with the jaw. Grab a melon head from a wandering trader, set the stand to small, and turn gravity off. From there, go to rotation, and rotate it either left or right 45 degrees. From there, you can turn the stand invisible and start to place it using the adjustment wand. You'll want to place it so that it's on top of the stem you placed earlier. The center corner of it should be aligned with the center of the flower pot. Next, go to the rotation menu and set the rotation angle to 15 degrees. Next, in pose adjustment, we're going to alternate the head's X and Z axis so that the head is tilted. Once your stand is in position, make sure to lock it. For the head, we're going to follow the exact same process as we did with the jaw, and we're going to move it up above where the jaw is sitting. In pose adjustment, alternate the X and Z axis the opposite direction from the jaw. This will give it a sort of open mouth effect. Once you think you've got the placement where you'd like it, lock the stand. Now we're going to give Clarence some teeth. In your book, click Paste to paste the pose you had earlier and give it some coral. Rotate the coral 45 degrees to the left or to the right. Turn the stand invisible, and then use your adjustment wand to get it into place above the jaw. Make sure the coral is sunken into the jaw a little bit so that it looks like it's part of the plant. Lock your stand when it's done. All we have to do for the other side is follow the same system with the alternate rotation. All that's left to do now is give him some eyes. So place the stand down, paste your pose from earlier, give him a sunflower, and then use your adjustment wand to place those wherever you like on the face. I like to poke the flowers into the melon a little bit, both to add expression and again to solidify that it is part of one singular object. Repeat the same process on the other side. You'll see in my version, I actually skewed the eyes a little bit to make him look a little goofier. And that's the fun of making a Clarence, is you can play with the expression as much as you like. So long as the same basic design is there, it works. And there you go, you've made yourself a Clarence. I hope you enjoy this project, and hopefully play with his design a little bit on your own. thanks for watching. I hope he brings a smile to your world just like he does mine. And so next time...